big work about Jesus. Obviously, we are informed about the discussion there are in Great Britain about this issue, but we are acquainted with discussion during the preparation of the visit of the Pope. It is not the first time there are some criticisms or problems, and this is rather normal, I think. We know that not everyone is ready to expect the coming of the Pope with total readiness and happiness, but the large majority is. And in this sense, we have a long experience that even if there were criticism and discussion before the coming, then the visit of the Pope was normally a success. It was the great majority of the population was very happy to listen to what the Pope had to say, to understand better who he is. And we have a very positive attitude. In this sense, we are not afraid, we are not too preoccupied by these discussions. We think that the Queen, Her Majesty the Queen, has invited the Pope, the government has invited the Pope, the Catholic Church, and also many other people are very, very interested in the coming of the Pope and are very ready to accept and to receive him and to listen to him. In this sense, we are sure that the visit will be a very happy occasion of dialogue, of positive contribution of the Catholic Church to the society in Great Britain. Very friendly attitude and positive, and in this sense, we are experimenting a good time also in the preparation of the visit. I would like to do the example of this visit to say that there were also discussion before the coming, because with the reasonable controversy there were discussion about the relations between Pope and the Catholic Church and Islam. But then the visit was a wonderful occasion to demonstrate the real attitude of the Pope toward Islam, an attitude of dialogue and of respect. I remember personally the visit to the Blue Mosque in Istanbul as one of the most beautiful moment of this visit, how the Pope was ready to listen to the Imam, to demonstrate a very sincere respect and interest for the holy place, for the Muslim, and all the explanation that the Imam was giving him. And I think that these images of the Pope listening with great respect to what the Muslim leader was saying him were the better demonstration of the positive attitude of dialogue and of friendship of the Pope. There are different personalities and way of communicating, but also this Pope is a great communicator in the sense that he has so rich and profound contents to offer in his speech, in his documents, that this is also communication. The communication is not only exterior, is also a problem of what you give as a content of your communication. In this sense, Benedict XVI is a man that has always very much to offer profound reflection, positive attitude, and a profound love for the truth. That is, he is not trying to have success, he is trying to say you what he thinks is really the best for you to know and to think and to reflect, even if this can be a matter of problems, of interior discussion and because you have to be honest toward the reality and the problems of today. In this sense, he is always giving a positive perspective, the Christian perspective, the perspective of civilization, of love, of dialogue, of harmony, of development of the human person, of peace and justice in the world. There are very, very positive values to give, and the Pope tried to give in his speech, in his contribution, but also with a very profound love of the truth, not no lie.
Italia,
sei
Italia.
Benedetto, amen, alleluia. Sei
Benedetto. Hi. Hi.